Martina Hirschmeier and I'm very happy to introduce you today to Stefan Leipold. He's the inventor of the magnetic private screen and we actually got to know each other in New York City. So he's sitting in New York City at the moment. Hello, Stefan.
Beautiful good morning and beautiful good afternoon to you. How are you?
Thank you. I'm very good. We are talking to each other today because it's a cyber crime month. So why is there such a month? Are we in danger? What's the problem?
I think it's just for the US government and I think a lot of international corporations try to do their living best to increase awareness in order to fight cyber crimes.
Yeah. So cybercrime is actually a big topic. Like, for instance, if we are using Facebook, if we are using WhatsApp, if we are using Tinder, all these dates are actually used. So how do they use our data? What's the story behind everything?
When it comes to social media apps or dating apps, most of us will sign in with their Facebook account. So in this case, you grant these apps, for example, Tinder. If you take Tinder and you go to your policies of Tinder in Section 8, you will see that you grant these apps full access to everything on your phone. And then even if you remove the app, you still have granted the access, which you have to remove manually as well. And these data are basically pure money. So if you consider, for example, if you take the example of New York, if I want to make a targeted advertising campaign and I want to target people that make more than $200,000 and live on the East Side, these are the information that these companies have. If people sign up with Facebook, a lot of people answer honestly saying their income, their email address, their physical address, and all this data is worth money.
Wow, that's a lot. And you say even if I delete Tinder, if I delete maybe the Facebook Messenger, this data is still out there and they can still use it. And they still have the access to our phones.
Yes, if you don't remove the access, the interesting part is if you go to the App Store and you look into the app yourself, you will see actually who owns the app. There can be an app that all the data is in Hong Kong, like Seek.com is a Chinese dating app. So a lot of people have it sign in and your data is going through Chinese servers. So it doesn't really matter if the Chinese are good or bad or whoever has the data. It's just simply that if you use this kind of data before you actually just sign in, you can actually take the options and see what are you willing to share. That has been done after the GDPR was actually implemented in Europe. So you can share your email, phone, contact and pictures. You can actually say no, no, no. And most of the people are not aware of it.
Okay, but what do I do if I agree to everything? If I still have these apps on my phone, or if I have deleted these apps, how do I actually get rid of the access?
So if you want to get rid of the access that you granted before, yes. You can actually go into your Facebook, then you go into the settings, and I think it's privacy settings, apps using my account, and there you will find the apps and you can remove them.
Mm-hmm. Is the data consumption of these companies also a reason why the data use of the phone is so high?
There's two particular reasons. A lot of people have their phone set up to auto-update all their apps, so that's permanently done in their background and drains the battery. But the second part is we tested the phone with a particular dating app, and we had 1.5 gigabyte data transferred without the phone not being even in the app. So that means somebody transferred data off there. So data is being taken. That's pretty much what it comes down to.
Why is data taken? Why do they want to have it? I mean, we are just normal people. Why do they actually want to have our data?
Yeah, I mean, there's basically two reasons. One, of course, is always financial background. And the second part, obviously, is law enforcement. Especially in the United States, we have Section 215. After 9/11, it was implemented. That basically means if you have any contact outside the United States, the U.S. government is allowed to monitor and copy all your data for 30 days. And most of the people are not aware of it. So if you are actually coming to this country and you are actually making a phone call, sending an email outside the United States, which would be Spain, Germany, et cetera, you are actually subject to be monitored. So it doesn't need to be that it's done, but the U.S. government has full right to do so and other governments as well.
You are also working with the government in the States, and I think you are also working with other governments. Obviously, you are not allowed to tell us what exactly you're doing with them, but what can you tell us about your cooperation or about your work for the government?
From time to time, we just get asked to assist and do some corporate work, because the fact is I do the technology part since I'm 5 years old. So that means I have a lot of knowledge. So when somebody just studies this kind of topics, get certified, get a degree, there's a difference of studying a topic and having experience. And so sometimes an outside contractor is needed in order to get stuff done, get data of certain systems, etc. So, yeah.
So you're in a way the Edward Snowden.
I don't know about that, but I think in general speaking, all the governments right now need cybercrime. If you take a look at Germany, right? Germany just published numbers that the German government faces 65,000 hacking attacks a day. So the defense system needs to be solid proof if you consider what kind of information could be stolen from, like, defense, military, political plans, et cetera, et cetera. So you need people that are very well, obviously ethically on the right side, plus also very well educated in order to do the job.
You're going to do a very great job. Sorry, you're going to do a great job today as well in New York City, where you're going to hold a speech in front of 200 CEOs in the headquarter of Microsoft. So what will be the topic today?
So we call it Cybersecurity 101. So I speak for Microsoft across the US. And so this today topic is, A, how do you keep your personal data safe? And most importantly, how do you secure your kids' data? Kids going online, they are online predators, cyber bullies, online stalkers. And so we educate every business person or individual, because business people also have kids and family, how to secure, for example, an Xbox or a mobile device, how to not just give a kid a phone and then it can be quiet in the corner, but on the side it watches somebody from ISIS beheading a person. So we educate them on how to find sources where you can actually limit devices and monitor what your kid is doing. And secondly, the US government has a couple of websites, so does the Germans and probably other governments as well, how to be aware if your kids get cyberbullied and how to deal with kids, because obviously natural behavior, if you tell a kid, don't do this, the first thing they do is they exactly do that. So we educate them on these pages and the information, educate them on how to keep your private life safe as well. And the life, obviously, of your children is most important.
Kidnapping actually got a big topic as well. How many people, how many kids are kidnapped in the States at the moment per year?
The alarming number, it's not only kids, can also be young adults. So last year it was 463,000 individuals has been taken, or
this is nearly a million. This is a half a million.
And the dark number, it's across, it can be into like human trafficking, whatever it is. And most of the people, even I travel all over the world and I see people always on the phone and then the kids like running around in the supermarket and people are not aware that it takes 6 seconds to abduct the child. So we
just do 6 seconds. Yeah.
6 seconds. So we do a living best to raise awareness. Like, if you're with your kid, be with your kid. If you need to be on the phone, hold your kid's hand. Don't just let it run around and then you wonder the kid is gone, because that must be one of the worst experiences in your life when your kid got abducted.
Yeah. Thanks a million, Stefan. This is such an important topic. Thanks a million for bringing us into this topic. And I hope you will have a very great speech today at Microsoft. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mike. A pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Thank you.
Thank you.